All right, we were just talking about Batman in Hollywood here a second ago. Let me take you into the world of fiction. I've been reading a book all summer. We've been telling you about some of the best books to read while you're on the beach or relaxing around the pool. This one, the plot really centers around the one question. If your son was killed in Iraq and you had the means and the resources to do something about it, would you go out and take the dirt bags out yourself? At what point is it good and what point is it bad to become a vigilante? The name of the book is The Assassin. Its author is Stephen Kuntz. Steve, welcome to the program. Glad
Thank
you're
you,
here.
Glenn.
By the way, as Steve brought in a pitchfork to shovel. What was it to shovel? Not sure what it is to shovel, but thank you very much. The book I've been reading, it is, I know we talked earlier today, it is Batman in the same way that the characters in the book are frustrated by being bogged down by all the meaningless rules that stop you from doing what needs to be done.
Right, and I think that's one of the great themes of fiction, you know, is that we could somehow be a hero and help solve some of the problems that we see in our society and without having to obey all the rules.
Do you think this, because the book starts out with a guy whose son has just been killed in Iraq. He goes to the White House, or he asks the president to come to his hotel room across the street from the White House, and he says, I want to have an off-the-record conversation with you. Give me a name, because I want to start an army.
Right.
And get these guys. Do you think it's possible that something like that is happening? Are there people like that?
Well, Ross Perot's name immediately comes to mind, you know, as a person with the means and the will to actually do what he thought had to be done, you know.
Yeah.
And he rescued his employees out of Iran whenever they were the great embassy crisis way back when. And so, yes, I think it could happen, and I think there are people that are probably helping our government and don't want their participation in that help to be public knowledge, of course.
We were just talking a minute ago. There's this big, huge Hollywood blacklist thing going on now with John Voight and what he talked about. And there is a unwillingness in America to call bad guys bad guys.
Indeed. Everybody wants to be politically correct.
Right.
They don't want to label the janitor. He becomes a custodian, you know, a building maintenance engineer.
When did that happen to us? Because Clancy used to be able to write about, you know, the evil Soviet Empire and the evil Nazis. Now we're still going back to the evil Nazis.
Mm-hmm.
When did that happen? Is it just the war on terror? Is it just radicalized Islam?
I think that whenever as a people, decide that all cultures have equal value and equal weight, then we begin to worry about insulting somebody, when in truth of the matter, all cultures don't have equal weight. You know, Western civilization was built by the Judeo-Christian ethic, you know, work, and then the secular society that we live in today that allows live and let live. And so we see the Islamic fundamentalists who don't believe in that.
I'm trying to remember what you called the Islamic fundamentalists, the radicals, you call them?
Well, Islamic Nazis, and that's certainly been used before by people who are not politically correct.
Right. And I think you on the radio today, you called them the something of civilization, the scourge of civilization or something.
Yeah.
I mean, you
and
don't hear it very often.
I think they are. They're enemies. They're enemies of the Western civilization that we hold so dear, that allow people to find their own way through life.
Right.
And the real question is, are we going to let these people dictate the shape of the civilization in the future, or are we going to fight back?
I have to tell you, you're going to read this book, and you're absolutely going to love it, because you will see the question of, do I stand around and be a part of the solution, or am I part of the problem, and the way it's solved in The Assassin by Stephen Kuntz. Thanks, Steve.
Thank
Appreciate
you.
It.